watching WGAL 8.
Headquarters in California's Silicon Valley and all around the world, people are paying tribute to Apple co-founder Steve Jobs today. Jobs died of pancreatic cancer yesterday at the age of 56. Oh, he created much of the technology that has changed the world and the way we communicate. Joining us tonight to talk about Steve Jobs' impact is Lawrence Knorr. He is a computer science professor at Harrisburg University. Good evening, Mr. Knorr.
Good evening.
Well, let's begin with the obvious. So far, 250 million iPods, iPhones and iPads have been sold, and that doesn't even count the computers.
Right. Yeah, he certainly had an impact. Many have said today that we've lost a visionary, but I don't think that quite captures it. I think what we've really lost is the great integrator of our time. He was able to take other people's inventions and ideas and bring them together into world-class products that consumers just loved. He transformed consumer society, and not only in the United States, but worldwide.
Yeah, some are saying his legacy can be compared to Albert Einstein or Thomas Edison. Oh, this is kind of cool, the way he's being mourned with the devices he created. The Associated Press reports in Tokyo, they're actually holding up flickering candles on their iPads.
Yeah, I'm sure there's many creative ways that we could do that. You know, I worry, though, that some have said that we're at the end of an era in this country, and he's sort of the bookend for it. I hope that's not the case, but maybe some years from now we'll look back and realize that it was the end of an age of innocence, an end of an age of invention that maybe started with Franklin and went through, you know, the telephone, Edison and electricity, the Wright brothers and so on, up until Bill Gates and Steve Jobs.
Yeah, well, when he stepped down, I think it was August 24th, and put Tim Cook in his place, I think he felt he was handing over the reins to someone who was more than capable. By the way, I wanted to share this, Mr. Knorr. If you invested in his little company back in 1997, 100 shares would have cost you about $1,370.
Right.
Today, worth $150,600.
That's amazing.
All right, Harrisburg University Professor Lawrence Knorr, thank you for being with us tonight.
Thank you.